Hello and welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to start a detailed discussion about taxonomic categories. But before that, I want to remind you about my last video, which has some basic terms related to classification. Those are taxonomy, systematics, and taxonomical categories. Okay, in that we have discussed taxonomy, systematics in detail, and then taxonomic categories. And obviously, the taxonomic categories includes the hierarchy, taxonomical hierarchy, in which it's the biggest or say largest level is kingdom. From starting from kingdom, we'll move to phylum, then class and order, then family, then genus, and then species. Okay, so this is about the recap of the last video. So today we are going to take up these taxonomical hierarchy in detail. Okay, so let's get started. So the category, I have already mentioned that the category is a part of overall taxonomic arrangement. Okay, so how can we define category? The category is a part of overall taxonomic arrangement and it is called taxonomic category. Okay. And this is called taxonomic category. Means in taxonomy, if we are going to arrange categories in a form, okay, and that taxonomy, if we are going to arrange categories in a form, that is called taxonomic category. Okay, and all categories together constitute the taxonomic hierarchy. And all categories together constitute the taxonomic hierarchy. Hierarchy is nothing but a arrangement in a orderly manner. Okay, so just the arrangement in orderly manner is known as hierarchy. And if this hierarchy is being used in taxonomy, then we'll call it as a taxonomic hierarchy. And as we have already discussed, what is taxonomy? Taxonomy is nothing but the branch of science which deals with the identification, nomenclature, and classification of organisms. Okay, I guess this much part is understood by you. So let's move to the next one. So each unit is referred to as a unit of classification in this. Okay, and represent a rank which is commonly called taxon. So each unit is referred to as a unit of classification which represents a rank commonly called taxon. Okay, commonly called taxon. Let me erase this thing first. Okay, so commonly called taxon. Clear? So यहाँ पे क्या है कि अगर कोई भी यूनिट है, हर एक यूनिट यहाँ पे एक क्लासिफिकेशन की यूनिट की तरह काम करेगी एंड उसको हम लोग नॉर्मली क्या कहेंगे, टैक्सन. ओके, एंड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ कैरेक्टर्स ऑफ एन इंडिविजुअल और ग्रुप ऑफ ऑर्गेनिज्म, सो वी कैन प्लेस देम इन वेरियस कैटेगरीज. सो व्हाट वी आर सेइंग हियर इज on the basis of different characters which are shown by the two organisms, let it be a two organisms, okay, if they are showing similar characters, we'll place them in a same category, and if they are showing both are showing different characters, then we'll place them in different categories. Okay, this is a sorting type of thing we do in naming, identification and classification of organisms. Okay, so let's move to the first point. Okay, hierarchy, taxonomical hierarchy unit, that is the lowest, we'll take the lowest one first. And that is our, what are the lowest hierarchical unit is? It is species. Okay, so we'll start with the lowest one, that is species, and this is important as well. Okay, so species, this term was first given by a scientist named John Ray. Okay, but its biological concept was given by Ernest Mayr. Another important point is its biological concept was given by Ernest Mayr. Okay, and what was that biological concept? It includes, what is a species? Species is that which includes a group of closely related organism which can interbreed, in nature, and produce fertile offsprings. See, this definition includes a number of points, right? So let's get started. Let's get the discussion on this begin. Closely related organisms. Okay, means what? Closely related organisms, what? What is this? So closely related organisms are those organisms which has same ancestral origin, or they belong to the same gene pool. Okay, means they should be related, their ancestors should be same, or we can say that their gene pool should be the same. Okay, so what is these closely related organisms? Their gene pool should be same or their ancestor should be same. Okay, so and another point is which can interbreed. Those closely related organisms should interbreed in nature and should produce a fertile, means infertile nahi hona chahiye, fertile offsprings. Okay, this is known as the species. Okay, in this we are going to take up few exceptions. Okay, this is not visible clearly, right? Let me erase this. Here we are going to take exceptions. Now we have two exceptions in number. Okay, so let me take the first one. So first exception is mule. Okay, mule is a cross product of donkey and horse. Okay, and in this donkey is the male and horse is the female. Okay, but what we have found is that the product or the offspring produced by this donkey and horse mating results in a formation of hybrid, and this hybrid is what? Sterile. It's not fertile, it's sterile. Okay, in that case we have another hybrid that is known as hiney, and this is product of horse and donkey, same, but here the sexes changes, horse male partner and donkey female partner, and in this case also the product is sterile, the offspring is sterile, this hybrid is sterile. And more interestingly, that in this these are through natural process, they are not kept in captivity, but this is the natural process, and these can interbreed, but the offsprings produced are sterile. Okay, so let's take another example. That is our second exception, which has trigon and liger. Trigon, tiger, and lioness. Okay, trigon is a offspring or the hybrid produced by the mating of crossing of tiger and lioness, and liger is lion and tigress. Okay, and in this case the product is fertile, the offspring produced is fertile. Here in both the case, in both the hybrids, in both the cases the hybrid produced are fertile, and more interestingly only in captivity, they are kept in captivity only, not in natural form. We have seen that the definition includes the closely related organisms which can interbreed in nature. Okay, But in nature, we have found that they are closely related, but they are producing sterile hybrid. Whereas if we kept these in captivity, the closely related organisms, if we kept them in captivity, they'll produce hybrid that are fertile. Okay, so let's take some examples to understand what the species actually is. Okay. These are the exception. Up to here we have defined the biological concept and the exception in that. But now we are going to explain the species examples. Panthera tigris. Okay, Panthera is the genus. Let me change the color. Okay. Before that, I need to underline this. Okay, so Panthera is the genus, and Tigris is the species. Okay, clear. Same, we have take. We should take another example as well. Here, Magnifera. Mangifera indica. Here also this is genus and this is species. Let's take another example. Homo sapiens or sapiens. Homo. This is your genus and this is your species. So the species are closely related organisms which can interbreed in nature to produce fertile organisms. Okay, and one important thing I want to highlight here is that species is the smallest and most closely related. Okay, as we move upward, as we move from species to kingdom, we'll find that the categories are including more and more organisms, and the diversification is the diverse species. As much as I can say that the more and more diverse group is forming. Okay, more and more diverse thing is going to it's a diverse group that is going to be formed. Okay, so today we are stopping here. We'll take up in the next video about the remaining taxonomical hierarchy, that is genus, family, order, class, phylum or division, and kingdom. Okay, so till then, do subscribe, like and share, and if you have any doubt, drop that in the comment section. Okay, so take care and stay safe and keep listening and keep reading. Thank you very much.